today, not only to see this beautiful building, but to listen to our next mayor of New Smyrna Beach. Let's hear some yay out there, some yelling. Mr. Chase Herbig, we thank you, sir.
Thank you.
What a wonderful event.
Thank you. You know, I've served for the last 4 years on the city's Economic and Development Advisory Board. And I'll tell you something, I have talked to, over the last several weeks, citizens that share the same issues that we discussed over the last 4 years. Growth has been on the top of the list. It's been smart growth, I've heard that, no growth, some growth, little growth, quality growth, and on and on and on. That in itself is a very deep conversation, but I will tell you that growth needs to be complementary to our city and our vision of how we want the future to look like. This is no longer, folks, a dress rehearsal. We have got one opportunity to get this right. We have some of the brightest minds in our city, but we also need to give them some autonomy to work their magic. I want to say that what's really big on my mind is that I am such a believer in giving back, and I want to make sure that we understand that serving the community is very key here. But I want to tell you that we can have all of these problems and talk about all these problems, but until you actually have a leader that can fight for you, it's not going to happen. I learned leadership, folks, when I was 18 years old in the Marine Corps. I taught some of the toughest Marines and recon in covert operations in the water. And I can tell you something, I learned to be tough. Also, I had 10 years in the corporate management side. I was known to be a guy, a go-to, that could get the job done. I'm a cool, calm, and collected kind of guy. That doesn't mean I'm a pushover, and never will be. But I can get the job done. We have a lot of agenda to take care of. I built and own one of the largest insurance brokerage firms in Central Florida. We still have 3 locations here in Volusia County. I am a native from here. I was born in Daytona Beach. So I'm very intimately involved in Volusia County. I don't need this job, and I can tell you that. The pay, I don't know, the pay's pretty good. It's about 20 grand a year, I think. So I was going to give it to charity, but once I looked at all the work that I have to do, may not be able to, but I still might do it. But the thing that I want to say to you is that, look, here's the deal. I'm doing this for you, and I'm doing it for this city. I'm not doing it for me. No glory. I don't need it. I've got, my wife is the greatest rainmaker in the world, and I have 2 children. And when I talked to them and everybody came up to me and said, hey, we need you to run for mayor, I was like, well, why don't you? You know, and they told me why they thought I should run for mayor. Went to my family and they said, look, you've always been a giver. You've always been a servant to people. And we want you, Dad, to be the mayor. So. My commitment, I won't let you down. Thank you very much. Woo!
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June, I said that's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it let it get me down. 'Cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself laying flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life.
That's life.
And I can't deny it. Many times I thought of cutting out, but my heart won't buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come this here July,